We are in Breda at the moment at the Information Builders International Summit, where I'm speaking with Rodney Monroe, who is a retired chief of police from Charlotte Mecklenburg. Welcome.
Well, thank you. Glad to be here.
Can you tell us something? You did a presentation earlier this morning on policing and law enforcement and analytics. Can you tell us something about the use of predictive analytics in law enforcement?
Well, I think it's an opportunity for police departments to move away from being reactive in the way that it's policing to a more proactive. And analytics, predictive analytics, allows you to take the data that you have, to mine that data, to look at different factors associated with that data, and to deploy your resources in a much more efficient manner.
What are the major benefits? Can you tell us something about the benefits that you've encountered?
Well, you know, first and foremost is the reduction in crime. When you're able to pre-deploy your people in areas where you believe or know that certain criminal activity occurs, you can prevent that activity, although you may shift that activity, but it gives you an opportunity to even pre-deploy into those areas that you believe that crime may shift to. So the greatest benefit is the overall reduction in crime.
Okay. Can you name some more, perhaps?
Well, I think it brings confidence to your workforce, knowing that they're working based on real data, not based on hunches, not based on different belief, anecdotal type of information, but real facts that they can see and understand on a daily basis.
How did deployment of information builders help you at the police department to get an integrated view?
I think it really helped, you know, us to bring together a team of people throughout the organization to really see and understand how analytics can help support what we do. And I think by, you know, having information builders helping us to assemble that team, and we built it from the inside out. It wasn't something that they just put in our laps and said, hey, use this. They allowed us to work with them to focus on the things that were concerning to us and to build it from within. And I think that's what made it much more acceptable throughout the organization.
We're in Europe, and can you tell us what would be your advice for European police departments when trying to implement a data-driven culture?
I would say first and foremost is that, you know, law enforcement, I don't care whether you're in the U.S. or you're in Europe or Canada, police departments are data-rich. We collect information on everything, calls for service, arrests, recoveries, you name it, we collect it. And I think having the opportunity to merge that data into a system that allows you to see it from different levels, not just in its own isolation, but to be able to mine that data, arrest data, with calls for service data, with crime data, I think that gives you a much greater picture of what's going on in your community and why it's going on and when it's going on and how it's going on. So my advice would be, don't be afraid to unleash the data that you already have.
Finally, what would you like to add from your experience?
Well, you know, I think that, you know, in law enforcement today, we have an enormous amount of challenges facing us. But one of those challenges shouldn't be data. People want to know what's going on, and I think the greater opportunities that we have to share that data both internally and externally with our citizens that we serve, I think the greater amount of trust and legitimacy that we build within our own organizations.
Well, thank you very much.
Thank you.